Sorry, the class is open. Okay, as you already know, we have completed the module 4 in the previous class. So even all the modules, all the classes of all the modules have been uploaded. You can go to our JC Ethernet YouTube channel, then you can check for IMC, okay, Integrated Marketing Communication. If you search there, the playlist will be there, like relating to the from first class till today as of now. So after the class, after a half an hour or 1 hour, it will be uploaded. Okay, and if you want this class, you can go and check out. Okay, so fifth module, the heading is monitoring, evaluation, and control. Okay, so till now we saw different types in which the company is basically trying to communicate, plus different media channels, different media vehicles. Okay, so now monitoring, evaluation, and control. So after looking at all the different things, now so just doing it will help you, may help you, we never know, but to find out that we want to monitor it, evaluate it, and control it. In the sense, when you are monitoring it, okay, you'll get to know what is happening over there. Monitoring, this is you are basically trying to find out what is happening, then you are evaluating the things that you got, okay, things you have got. In the sense, whatever data you are getting by monitoring, okay, you are evaluating it, whether it is whatever efforts you are putting. So are you basically getting the results of it, whether it is effective to whatever the amount you have thought, whether it is performing better than that or it is underperforming. So if it is underperforming, you want to check, okay, where all I need to make changes. So that is where is the control part comes in. Okay, so we need to find out why it is not basically working as I thought of. If not, okay, then what needs to be changed? So that is where we are telling the monitoring, evaluation, and control. Okay, so reasons to measure effectiveness. I was talking like why we need to do it. So first, avoid costly mistakes. So because you know ads and not only like print ads or the TV ads and all, they cost you a lot of money. Okay, so just without knowing whether it will work or no, or just continuing it without understanding, okay, is it having a required amount of impact on the customers or on the public or not, so you are basically making mistakes and it is very costly affair. So it is called as avoiding costly mistakes. Okay, we'll look at these four things in deep, okay, or in general. So second one is evaluating alternative strategies, then increasing the efficiency of advertising in general, then determining if objectives are achieved or not. The first one, avoiding costly mistakes. So what is this? Huge money is being spent on advertising. I already told you, like, to give a certain, we have already calculated all those things, like for TV ad and for print ad, how much it will cost you. So usually it goes to, like, in print ad, it comes to CPM, that is cost per 1,000. So in TV ads, we are saying TRP, GRP, so how to calculate per person's cost, reaching per person's cost and all. Okay, in the module 3, so you can go there and you can check. Okay, so stating all these things, so we are basically spending more on advertising. Then to avoid wastage due to ineffectiveness of ads. So even we spoke about waste coverage and all. Waste coverage in the sense, you are exposing your ads to those people who are not your target audience. Okay, who may, even if they see, they will not come and buy your products. Okay. So such kind of people, like if you are having a pencil and a eraser ad, okay, you are producing pencil and eraser, your target audience are the preschool and the primary school children. If you are showing it to college children, and if you are targeting more of college children, it is very rarely that they use pencil and pen. I mean, sorry, pencil and eraser. So unless they are drawing a graph or so. So if they buy one pencil, they can use it for years together. Okay, but school children, it's not so. So they need frequent pencils and erasers because they'll be losing it. Okay, they'll be using usually that's the main thing which with they write. Okay, so they are not allowed to use pens and all. So majorly the work is from pencil. So you are basically targeting the primary children and the pre-primary children. Okay, but as I told you, waste coverage. Okay, so you need to just find out whether it is effective or not. So how well is your okay, basically it is working or not. Then to avoid opportunity loss due to poor communication or due to ads not meeting its objective and missing on the potential gain that would have occurred to the firm. In the sense, you know, as you are not monitoring it, you are just putting ads everywhere. Okay, so if it was effective, it would have brought a great deal of advantage to the organization or the company. Okay, but to know all those things, we need to have this particular evaluation. Okay, then comes missing on potential gain that could have accrued to the firm. Then it helps maximize investments. So why we call as investment? Where do we invest? We want to increase our money. Okay, basically over time. So those are called as investments. So investing something means you are looking for something in return back. Okay, return of investment. So we need to maximize this one. So if the investment is made, it's getting that I'll be getting like 500 customers. Okay, over a period of time. It could be a month, it could be a quarter, or it could be half a year or so. So whether are you reaching that, like with this particular campaign or with this particular ad that you have seen or that is what you are putting, so are you basically meeting the objective, okay, so of having around 500 or 600 customers for that specific period of time. So that is what I am telling. We are maximizing the investment. We want to maximize. So instead of 600, if 700 are coming, well and good, my campaign is working very well. But if instead of 600, I am getting only 200, that means there is something wrong. Okay, I am not targeting the right audience, or it is not reaching as effective as I want. Okay, or there is something wrong with my advertising campaign. So I need to go find out. So what reasons I give? These are some of the reasons and not all the reasons. So like this, we need to find out what all reasons are there. Then we need to change accordingly. So this is avoiding costly mistakes. Next. Evaluating alternative strategies. Second one. So now you know, like, whether it is working fine or no. If it is not, we need to find out the alternate strategies that are there. Okay, evaluating the alternate strategy. What all I have with me. So how well I am thinking of it works. Okay, so one that I thought of will work better, it's not working. Now I have to go to the alternative strategies. Okay, I might have one or I might have many. So we are again evaluating. We start evaluating the other strategies as well. So it helps to know which medium would be useful for what kind of communication. Okay, so again we are starting to evaluate now. So what kind of information or what kind of ad I am having and what kind of medium I am choosing. Okay, then alternatives like medium, messages, promotional programs, traditional versus non-traditional ads, etc. can be done. So alternative mediums, in the sense, just don't rely on one medium. Have multiple advertisements in multiple mediums. Okay, so traditional and non-traditional also we saw what kind of ads are called as traditional, what kind of ads are called non-traditional, like guerrilla marketing. Okay, we saw, so this is a kind of a non-traditional marketing or non-traditional ads. So we have to focus on both traditional as well as non-traditional. Then appropriation of budgets can be done better with evaluation. In a sense, if it is working well, you think you are a campaign is working better. Okay, we'll just check on other students. Okay, so just tell your friends if they want to come in now, they can. Okay, otherwise it will block because it is recording. Check with your friends if they want to come in, ask them to come in now. Because I'm hearing those voices, in the sense, when it that particular tune comes, that means somebody is trying to enter. So as it is, the recording is on, it will not allow to get in. Okay, I'll just wait for some time, then we'll go back. Okay, then we'll move back to the. Okay, alternatives done. Appropriation of budget can be done better with evaluation. That means whether it is working, can I continue with it or should I stop the budget over there? This is putting budgets in that particular medium or not, or should I go to a different strategy? Just for that, my budgets are very important. if this is not working, I can stop here and I can go with full force in a different medium. So if I split the amount in this and in some other media, so it may work, okay, or it may not work. But if you're putting everything, so we are encouraging more, we are giving more enforcements over there, okay. So chances are there, if one is not working, the other may work. But only thing is, how you will get to know? By evaluation. So after evaluation, you will get to know whether what you are doing is working for you or not. Then different strategies can be evaluated. So you already will be having different marketing strategies. So we need to find out if one is not working, which one would be the next best. Then effectiveness of different ads can be done. In the sense, how well this particular different ads is happening. Okay, what percentage of objective is being trying to complete in what amount of time. So we have seen even media strategies and all. So whether those kinds of strategies are being met, sorry, not strategies, objectives are being met by this kind of strategy or not. This is evaluating alternate strategies. Then increasing the efficiency of advertising in general. So how to increase the efficiency? So it helps you understand if the ad message is understood by the targeted consumer correctly or not. We have discussed about this. So a particular marketer wants to portray this particular ad or this product in a certain way, okay, through the advertisements. But the person who is decoding it, the person who is receiving it at the receiving end, if he is also thinking in the same lines, then yes, the right message is being taken in the right way. If not, if it is decoded in a different way, which it was not intended to, the company or the product may land in trouble. Okay, so many times it has happened where they wanted to show something, but people took it in a different way. Okay, especially when you are dealing with religion, customs and all, it is, you need to be very, 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 very careful. Okay, it could be anything that could have triggered it. Okay, like, it's not an advertisement, but I could tell you, like, one of the series, okay, one of the series, you know, OTT platforms are there, so many new series are coming. So similarly, one of the series which was there, okay, had to face a lot of issue, okay, due to the content. The content, in the sense, what they were showing and how they were portraying it. It was just a show, basically. But people started like linking it with so many things, okay. And there was a big issue on that. But still it is being aired and you can go and check out, okay. I'll just tell you the name, it's Thando. Okay, it's Thando, if you go and check. So there are a lot of political things, okay. It is based on a political party and politics, okay. So a huge issue that was have to be faced by these people, okay. So similarly, the next one, now I think in another 2-3 days we'll be getting a new one, Family Man 2. Again, it is under controversy because of where they are and how they are portraying a certain kind of people. Okay, so you might have seen this, or if you have not seen, you could like check in media, social media and all. So you're getting all kinds of issues like this with many things. So they think that, okay, we are just showing something, but from the other end, the people will not take it as it was shown, the intent, what it, they were having. So that could be felt in a different way to the audience. Okay. So that was a whole series, but we are talking about the advertisements here. But similar impact will be there on advertisement as well. Whether it was like hours together, we are having 10 episodes, 15 episodes, 8 episodes and all. But here we are having a small ad, okay, of around 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, which will be played in multiple number of times over a period of time again. Okay, so this could also have a very larger effect, because once somewhere a person might see it and he might think that, okay, I only might have misjudged it or so. But when you are showing again and again the ads, okay, the person will get to know, okay, so whether he was, whatever he heard was right or no, whatever he saw, it was the same thing or no. So your intention might be completely different as a person who is giving the ad, but as a person who is seeing at the receiving it, he might think it on a whole new different perspective. You might have not thought about it before, so people may think of that also as something different. So those things happen. So increasing the efficiency, okay, helps understand the message. Okay, this is done. Helps in correcting ads with too much jargons, okay, too much creativity, brand names not being conveyed for impact. This is jargon in the sense, it could be a sentence or a saying, okay, which goes like in all the languages you will be having some jargons basically. So how could I put them, jargons, okay, certain words which mean something, okay, so in one language it may mean something, the same thing it may not mean in the other, okay, the other people may not understand what was told. Okay, so similarly, I think most of the students watch movies of different region or different languages also. So in the beginning, you may not understand anything. Okay, but after a certain period of time, you will say, okay, this means this. What did the person mean by saying something? Okay, so some set of lines or set of words which mean a certain thing. So these are called as jargons. Then too much of creativity. Okay. So it might so happen that you are so creative that the minds of the people may not be able to process it. Okay, like some movies are there, like Inception and all. So you need to at least see them 3 to 4 times to understand what is happening over there. Okay, so that particular person, Christopher Nolan, he is very much famous for doing such kind of movies like Inception, and his recent movie is Tenet, T-E-N-E-T, Tenet, which is also available in. I think Amazon Prime, you can go and check out. So again, similar kind of theme, which is completely different. Again, to understand, you need to watch it multiple number of times. I may not tell you like 2 times or 3 times, based on your understanding, you should watch. Okay, so once a part of it you could understand, but if you watch it multiple number of times, you'll get to know actually what is being told to understand basically. So those things we are telling, like more of creativity. So which is very much hard to understand by the general people. Then brand names not being conveyed. So you're showing so much good ads, then such creative ads. But if you fail to portray that particular brand, okay, effectively, so it is waste. So people remember what is the ad, but they don't remember for what it was made. Okay, what brand it was made, what was the product. Okay, so that's why they portray a product in and the image and the brand in a way where you remember the brand. So which ad was that? So if you tell the name or tell the some music of it, so people will tell the brand or they tell the product. So that should be the main focus. You should not not make that particular brand or the product less visible. You need to make it more visible basically for people to understand what the ad is or for what the ad is on. Then helps ads to become efficient and effective. Okay, so if you are increasing the efficiency, is we are creating more impact. So that is what this means. Then helps handle the agent queries better. In the sense, sometimes you may have some agents. Okay, you may not be able to contact the companies directly, but agents are there, so helps handle the agent queries better. So if some queries are there, like how to take the agency, how to become a dealer of this particular things, okay, if it is intended for them, so it would be better understood if more information in a better way, in a way where they could understand. In that particular way, if you are answering or if you are showing a particular ad, that will help many people get a proper understanding of what you were saying basically. Okay, so this is increasing the efficiency of advertising in general. Then determining if objectives are achieved. Okay, so your objective would be, like I told you, like getting 600 customers in a particular product time of 6 months. Take 6 months. So if you are not evaluating or monitoring it, how will you get to know whether 600 people you have achieved or not? Okay, so to find whether the objectives are achieved or not yet, or we need to put more efforts. To know that, at least we need to evaluate and monitor. Since an IMC works on the principle of taking the customers through various phases. So we have seen like the Dagmar model. So different phases we are taking the customers. So first we will not be knowing what is the awareness phase. Then we are putting like giving more information. Like first awareness is I am there in the market, this is my product. Then more information of the product, like how different it is, how it will help them and all. Okay, then we are generating interest. Okay, then we are making him act. Act means making him buy. So as there are different phases in which a particular customer is going through, and with this only the IMC works. So it is necessary to understand if the customer has reached the level that was originally set as the objective for the communication. So new brands and new products in the market, what will be their objective? Their objective will be to reach more number of people as much as possible in that particular duration of time. Okay, more number of people in the sense based on how vast is your campaign. So you could make 3 lakh people, 5 lakh people in 15 days or 20 days or in a month based on how big area you are basically targeting. Okay, so to find out whether it is reaching or not, we need to have the monitoring done. Then only when the current objective is met, will the new objectives get set. In the sense, what we mean here is, so if you really come to know that this particular objective we have achieved, then we can go to new objectives. So as the goal was to achieve the objective, your goal is done. So you need to move toward the next goal, the next objective. So if it is framed well and good, if not, you need to frame a new objective, then work on it again. Then how the different program elements lead to or fail to achieve goal needs to be determined. In a sense, what were the major things which led to the achievement of this particular target or the objective? If on the other case, what were the elements that did not work well so that I couldn't reach my objective or I failed in reaching the objective? So these elements I need to find out. So when I find out those elements in the next time or the next campaign, okay, I would take notice that, okay, these elements, if possible, you can eliminate or need to be taken care of in a better way than what you did it. So to find even those, this evaluation and other things are done. Okay, then coming to what to test. So we just saw why to test or why to evaluate, not test, why to evaluate or why to analyze. Okay, then we are coming to what to test. So marketers need to determine how each component of the communication model. So what are the different components? So it is source, message, media, and the receiver. So which component and also other decisions made in the promotional planning process are progressing. In a sense, working in the way I was intending it to work. So which part of it was lacking or which part of it came to a better perspective than what I thought of. Okay, so here if you see source factors, message variables, media strategies and budget decisions. So these all variables after testing will have an impact on the further decisions. Okay, so coming to first one, source factors. So what are source factors? It is to find the answer to whether the spokesperson being used is effective and how the target market will respond to him or her. The source in the sense from where this particular message is coming. So it is not just the media or the broadcaster and all. So if a person is coming and speaking, like the way I am delivering this particular session for you guys. So if it was me, am I effective or not? Should I be changed? Okay. Is there basically trying to teach? Okay, and what I am teaching is exactly reaching in the way that I want you to understand. Okay, so example here, Tiger Woods was found to be effective to Nike and Yup. Okay, so when the Nike people used the Tiger Woods, so he's a golf player, number one, or almost in top 10. So there will be like most of the time, he was number one. Okay, Tiger Woods. He plays golf. So Nike, when they hired him, so it was very effective. Okay, because many people look to him as a legend. Okay, like how Sachin Tendulkar for cricket, like that Tiger Woods is for golf. Okay, so similarly, so who is the person who is communicating? Okay, so just if it is the voice, okay, it is different. If with the person, his voice and he himself, you can see him, that has a greater effect. Then some spokesperson may be excellent source initially, but may lose impact over time. In the sense, initially they might be very good, but over the period of time, they may not be that effective, okay, in the achieving the goals. Like for example, Britney Spears was used by Pepsi, okay, to target the youth. But after a time, a particular age, even she is a human being, so her age also will increase. So similarly, as and when time passed, okay, Britney will also age. So she may not be much effective to the youth because there might be new person. Okay, it could be like Justin Bieber or Selena Gomez or any other person, okay, who are now entering into that particular space. Earlier, where these people were there. Now, because of time, they are getting older and older and there are new people who are entering. So similarly, like cricket team, as and when players get old, they are replaced with the new and younger players. Similarly, this will happen. And for the advertisements also, so when you are targeting the youth, when Britney was there, yes, there could be youth who used to look at her, in the sense, she was more famous with her songs and all. Okay, so when she got older and older, there are new people who are entering. Now, she has to be dropped and new people has to be taken in the ads. So you might have seen many ads where earlier different people were there in terms of the cricket players also. So you might have seen earlier different people were there, now different cricketers are there. So earlier different film stars used to be there, now different film stars are there. Okay, so as the time passes, okay, the symbol for which you were known for, okay, could be taken for a different person. Okay, like changes in the source attractiveness or likability may lead to changes in source effectiveness. So if some controversy, if a person is like between a certain controversy, his brands leave them because that may impact the sales of that particular brand or that particular product. So many a times it happens. Okay, like example, it is common to see cricket players being removed from ads when their form fails. As and when like the cricket players may not perform because of bad form. Okay, they may not maintain the form for a longer period of time. In everybody's life cycle, you see people in form and out of form. So when the cricketers get out of form, okay, and out of form for a longer period, so they will be replaced or those ads will not be played at that particular moment. Okay, so when they come back to form, again they start like showing the ads. Okay. So these are source factors. Then message variables. So both the message and the means by which it is communicated are basis for evaluation. In the sense, what kind of message it is and how are you basically transmitting it to the customers. So all these things are also the basis for evaluation. Next, messages sometimes may not be strong enough to pull readers into the ad by attracting their attention or may not be clear enough to help them evaluate the product. Since message may not be able to attract the people or it might not provide more information about the product, what they are looking for or what you are basically marketing or what basically you are advertising for. So this is, okay, what you call a drawback or not a drawback. This could be taken as a failure of a message. Okay, if the message is not properly framed, or if it fails to attract people, or if it fails to tell the customers what it is intended to tell. Okay, then this is one of the variables, okay, of the message. You know, sometimes the message may be memorable, but may not achieve other objectives. In the sense, you may remember the message, okay, but it fails to get the sales of that particular product or get sales of that particular brand. So example, you can see one research showed that 7 out of 25 ads that scored highest on internet. Scored highest in the sense, it could be like how many people remember it, what kind of things were there into it, what they remember about the ad. So something like this, if you see on all some of these parameters, like what I told now, so these ads will be rated or scored. So what we are telling, our research showed 77 out of 25 ads that scored highest on internet and memorability, how many people remember the ad, had flat or declining sales. In the sense, it remained that much only, or the sales started dropping. Okay, so 7 out of 25 ads, like people were remembering the ad, but they were not buying the products. The sales became like was flat in the sense, where it was remaining the same. Even that is okay, but it should not fall, or it declined, it went down. And the message, headline, illustration, text, and layout may impact effectiveness. In the sense, how well you are saying, how well you are framing, what is the headline, what is the text message that is given, and in what way are you putting it forth in front of the customers. So even this has a greater impact on your message. Then media strategies. What media strategies? It is necessary to know which media class, in the sense broadcast media or print media, example we are giving. So which media class you are basically looking for or choosing. Then subclass. So under the media class, we are having subclass. Like in print media, we have newspaper or magazine. So which one are you going to pick? Or both. Okay, it could be multiple or it could be anyone. So what is subclass? Inside a particular media class, there will be subclass. Like here in this case, we have taken print media. Under print, we are having newspaper and magazine. Or specific vehicle. So we are getting more deeper now. Specific vehicle in the sense, which newspaper or magazine? If you're going for newspaper, which newspaper? Yeah, we saw different kinds of newspaper and where they are being circulated. So in that, which newspaper? So different newspapers are there in the market. So which one are you going to target? Or which one are you going to choose? Okay, whether it could be newspaper or the magazine. So this is the specific vehicle. We are calling this as media vehicle. So which exactly newspaper or which magazine exactly are you placing your ad? This is media vehicle. Then the location within a particular medium. Okay, second one, particular medium. Medium in the sense where, like for example, newspaper or a magazine. This is kind of a medium, print medium. So here, where are you putting it? In the front page, back page, middle page. Okay, then the size of the ad or the length of commercial. So how big is the ad? Okay, what is the font size of the writing there? Okay, all this is a kind of a strategy. So and each and everything costs, you know, even the length and breadth of a particular ad and how much written material is there, what is the font of it, what is the font size. So everything will have a cost. Okay, then that needs to be checked in this strategy. Then comes the evaluation of lighting versus pulsing versus continuous schedule is important due to increasing cost of media time. We have seen different kind of advertisements like lighting, pulsing and continuous. Lighting, you are basically airing a particular ad, then for some time you are not doing anything. Okay, sorry, lighting is full over the period of 12 months throughout the year. We are having same kind of advertisement. Okay, so that is lighting. Then pulsing, we are looking, we are showing the ad for some time, it could be some months. Okay, then we are not showing for some months, then again showing. So this goes on. And continuous schedule is both pulsing and lighting, where it is like continuously shown, plus at the time of a particular time, we are increasing the frequency. Okay, so this is most important due to increasing cost, because some people or some companies may afford this, some may not afford because of the cost. Okay, so it is not viable for some people, or it may not fit in the advertising budget of many small companies or small brands. Okay, who may not be able to afford this. Then there may be opportunity associated with increasing ads in periods of downward sales cycles or recession. There may be opportunity associated with increasing ads in periods of downward sales cycles or recessions. In the sense, we have to market more, or we have to spend more on the advertising when your sales is going down. Okay, you should say that I am in the market. If somebody thinks of a particular product, if you are doing it, they should think of your product to buy. Okay, or at a time of recession, when people think very, very much to buy something, because recession, the prices go very high and the income becomes less. Okay, so people who used to buy many things, many luxurious things, now they try to cut down on the things or the products what they buy. Okay, so still you need to have more of advertisement, so that on seeing multiple number of times, if they were earlier customer and they are not willing to buy now, but still when you show them, you remind them of the times when they used to buy it and have it, okay, or use it. So that makes people go and buy it again. Okay, the memories. Okay, so stating that I used to use it. Okay, I used to buy it. So at least with the frequency may fall, but still they may buy it. Like if they buy it earlier, like thrice a month or four times a month, like weekly once, you say. So they could buy 2 weeks once or monthly once, but there will be some sales. Okay, so it will not become zero. Then comes budget decisions. So this is necessary to understand if increase in ad budget would lead to increase in sales or not. If it is working fine, okay. So if you feel that, okay, if I put more money into this, then my sales may increase, or you are having a feeling on evaluating that, okay, this is not working for me, I'll stop the funding there, then I'll look for new media, okay, new kind of media. So this is where it helps in having budget decisions, whether to put more budgets there or to stop and start a new campaign or focus on new media. Okay, this is how budget decisions it will help in. Then there are two types of tests. Okay, pre-test and post-test. Pre-test in the sense before airing the ad we are testing. Okay, then post-test in the sense after airing the ad we are testing it. So this is pre and post. Pre is before, post is after. Okay, so what are pre-tests? So pre-tests are measures taken before the campaign is implemented. As I told you, before the campaign, before airing it. So pre-tests are measures taken before campaign is implemented. Then it can occur at many number of points. So we're all like idea generation. So we are testing the idea itself. Then rough execution. So if I execute it, how will it look? Okay, so small execution is done for pre-testing. Then to testing the final version. So rough execution in the sense you are testing it to make it perfect or to get the final version. So after final version is done, again you are testing it, okay, before implementing. So up to implementing, so whatever you are doing, testing just before implementing will all come under pre-test. So after implementing, whatever tests you do, those come under post-test. So more than one type of pre-test may be used, okay, we'll see. There are many kinds of pre-testing that could be done, okay, and again similarly there are many kinds of post-tests. So this is what is pre-test. So why we are doing it, the reason for pre-testing is to identify winners. In the sense, if you are having multiple ads, okay, so which one do you think will have the highest attraction rate for the customers, or which is having more percentage of increasing of sales? Okay, that is what is to identify winners. Then to enhance good ads. In the sense, the ad is okay, but we can make it better, or we can make it good. Okay, in the sense, it is fine now, it is acceptable. But is there any chance of making it better? So that can be done by retesting. Then to eliminate bad one. In the sense, if you are getting, like in the test you are getting, this will not work, or this is not a good one. So that means you are eliminating those ones. So after hearing it, then getting into controversy, then spending more money on it will not work, okay, or will have a lot of efforts and you are wasting money as well. So we are having pre-tests. So whether to check before the implementation or before the hearing of it, whether it works or not, do we have any issues with this, or can we have some issues later on, okay, after hearing. So everything has to be taken care of. So this is where we are having pre-tests. The methodologies to conduct pre-tests include focus groups. Okay, we are calling people from different, it could be place or different professions, okay, different age groups, the different genders. We are making focus groups like that. Then we are showing them the ad. Okay, then there, this is a kind of pre-test. We are testing it on the focus group, whether it works or not. Then where participants freely discuss the meanings, okay, they get from the ads. So if somebody sees something, then you'll ask, what was your opinion? What did you feel about it? Okay, what was the first thing that came into your mind when you see this particular ad or not? Okay, so this is where we are showing participants and asking them, so what actual meaning that you got from this particular ad? Then consider the relative advantage of alternatives. In the sense, this could be done for different kind of advertisements. Then ask them, which one did you feel was more effective? Okay, so a kind of pretest. Okay, then suggest improvements or additional things. So what do you think, how can they improve a particular ad? What changes they are looking for, if could be done. So you are getting more information. So this is some of the methodology. Then consumers may be asked to evaluate the ad on the series of rating scales. So you have already gone through different rating scales. Okay, continuous rating scale, Likert scale, and all other things are there. Okay. So based on a rating scale, a person is asked after showing that particular ad, they will ask like rate this particular ad from 1 to 10 or from 1 to 5. So 1 being what and 5 being what or 10 being what. Okay. So then a particular person rates the ad. If he feels it is very good, he will rate 9 or 10. If he feels it is the worst, then it will be like given 1 or 2. Okay, then in-home interviews. So going to homes and taking the interview, what do you feel about that? They'll show the ad and they'll say, okay. The same process is being done by going to homes. Then mall intercept. Mall intercept, you already know. People who come to mall, you are basically stopping them and asking some questions. You might have seen. Okay. So basically, the people who are going in or coming out of the mall, you are stopping them and asking some questions about so many things. Okay, showing them something and asking them the effectiveness, what did you see, what did you feel, okay, what was the message that you think that was given by this particular ad. So finding out all of this. Then laboratory method, that means you are taking them in a closed place, which is a room or something, which might be taken as a laboratory. Okay, so there are different methods which are done in closed rooms. Okay, this is laboratory methods. Then coming to post tests. What are post tests? I told you, after the implementation of the particular ad, okay, then you are having the test. So this is post test. Post test occurs after the ad or commercial has been in the field. So as I tell, it is aired in the sense it is transmitted or it is already sent or shown in multiple places. So here they are saying commercial has been in the field. Field in the sense in the market, in the media basically. It is designed to determine if the campaign is accomplishing the objective sought, whether it is working as per our requirement or not. Then serve as input into the next period situation analysis. So if I am going to the next one or the next product in my own brand, so can I use any inputs that I got here after the airing of this particular ad or after the post test? Okay. So whatever mistakes I have done in one campaign should not be repeated in the other one. Okay, so that is what we will get some inputs. This is post test. Here again, testing happens either in laboratory or field settings because it's everywhere available. So it could be in laboratory, like in between four walls, or it could be under field settings. In the sense, a particular setup is done, then they are. People are got over there, then you are testing them. So again, there are multiple post tests also. So in the coming classes, we'll look at them. So laboratory test, in this case, people are brought to a particular location where they are shown some ads or commercials. Okay, I told you, some in between four locations, they are bringing them to a particular location. The testers either ask questions about them or measure participants' response by other methods like pupil dilation, eye tracking, or galvanic skin response. So So just remember now, these are some of the methods. Okay, these methods we'll look in deep or in more depth. Okay, in the coming classes. Then this laboratory method provides control for the researchers. In the sense, it is at a controlled environment. So you can change, you can do some changes, you can ask so many things. Okay, you can make some changes in the ads. Okay, then it could be asked. It helps to assess different copies, illustrations, formats, colors, and the like, which can be manipulated inexpensively. In the sense, it could be in different formats. Illustration is in different way it has been shown. Okay, then in different copies, then in different colors. Like for example, a print ad. So if I do it in everything in black, how it looks, everything in red, how everything in yellow, or a mixture of different colors. Okay, multicolor ad is being shown. So which color do you think where it comes or where it looks better? So can you read any word in this particular color or not? So all these things are being tested under laboratory test. Then it makes it easier to isolate the contribution of each factor. In the sense, you can distinctively say which one is effective and why, and which one is not effective and why again. So you can take necessary actions. Then field test. What are field tests? It is a test of ads or commercials under natural viewing situations. Okay, complete with the realism of noise, distractions, and other comforts of home. Like you're sitting at home and you are looking at it, like the fan is on, somebody is calling you, or you are on your phone. Okay, the commercial is being aired like that. So then they'll ask how effective it was. So did you feel okay to see the TV or wherever it is being aired? So all these things comes under field test. So it is according to the field. So there are many noises and distractions to a person when he is at a in a field. It could be a TV, it could be a in a theater, it could be at his house, it could be in his office. Okay, wherever a person sees a particular ad and how the environment he is in. So that is mimicked and basically tested. Okay, so testing process will start this in the next class. Okay, I hope you have understood why we are basically doing the tests, then what different kinds of tests are there, pre-test and post-test. Okay, what are pre-tests, what are post-tests? Okay, how these things are done. So fairly this particular module is very small. Okay, I'll try to go into as depth as possible to explain you what is being done, how it is taken. Okay, it is very, very small when compared to other modules. Okay, so it may get over very fast. So don't miss any of the classes. Okay, here we are getting into a zone where it is interesting now. Okay, you have seen so many ads, but do you know how it is being evaluated, how it is tested before and after? So what are the different ways of doing it? So this is a bit interesting, so don't miss the classes. And you already know this is where this classes will be uploaded. You can go and check over there as well. If there are any doubts or you miss something, if there are distraction or anything, go back, okay, to the YouTube channel and you can watch these particular things again. Okay, you can stop this particular class for today, and we can continue in the next class.